The internet gonna catch up. Back, back, back. I'm here. You motherfuckers. This will be Clock Paul. Clock Paul. Since it's a clock instead of Cock Paul. That's how I'm doing, motherfucker. I'm good. I'm on a little late. I am going to have an erratic streaming schedule this weekend because I have a very large painting to finish. And I'm going to be hopping on this weekend, I think, experimenting with... live streaming a 4-foot by 3-foot, you know, Cockpaw and Clockpaw, the indestructible, sorry me, the indestructible demons. Amazing, dude. Your command of the language astounds me. I know I'm fucking with you. Alright. You know what? I need, where's me old iPad? The old iPad of love. Let's look up a few reference things. What is that? It's like some... felt like I was rolling a booger, but anyway. I'm so glad spell check is... should be happy I pay attention to that. I'm always correcting my grammar and whatnot as I am talking to you individuals in chat. I like the idea of taking a cuckoo clock and mixing it with a grandfather clock and having a cuckoo cock clock, cock paw clock. Write that one down. I may need to update the stream title. Dude, you're so right. Twisted Metal. Clock Paw the Demons. Slayer is here. Update. Boom. Thank you for that. And yes, don't tell me how to run my fucking stream. The welder! What's up, dude? Alright. I brought out my fine. Just like I have amazing paper bowls. Look at this beat up tin cup. This is what we're drinking out of. It's water, not vodka. I can't stand that shit. I almost want like the face of the clock. This is just gonna look like a big fucking nipple right now, but banned. These cuckoo clocks, these are badass. Shut the heck up. This one's cool. It's got some gears, some little bird feathers. You have to correct me as I type. maybe wood swirling around, or and then the teeth are hanging off. Oh, that'd be kind of cool. What if we had all right, so this is the clock face. Let's put some arrows here before Twitch thinks I'm drawing a big titty. Want to eat some steak. Wait, ready to go home? Is it, oh, be, just ready to go home, or is it the end of the day for you? Let's see. I mean, we could do... yeah. I want to get kind of complicated with the clock here. So... there we go. We'll start off with a little wah. Bullets are cheap, and there's a lot of cows. Oh, yeah. But an axe is free. Sometimes. If you already own one. And then I think I want to go... I like the idea... Bear with me here. We're gonna get all Guillermo del Toro on this thing. This seems like something he would create. But of course it's Sean Dietrich. I don't emulate anyone. True. So I like the idea of the wood kind of collapsing and, you know, like on the original sketch, like having some of the wood planks come out and whatnot as, I mean, it could be hair or clock fur, cock paw clock fur, cock work orange. There we go. And then if I took wood up like this, yeah, and then, let's see. And then maybe like that. Okay. Yeah, Guillermo's a shit, dude. He got shafted when they decided not to do that Silent Hill project with him. I didn't really give a shit about Daryl from Walking Dead being in it, but man, Guillermo del Toro doing Silent Hill? I can imagine what the monsters would be like. He's like the king of creature design. He's like the Spanish Jim Henson, but for adults. I don't even know if that makes sense. All right, so what we'll do... These wood planks wrapped around are his gums. Yeah. And then we'll do some embedding in the wood here. Some embedding. Cool. Oh, I was looking on something online. I wasn't like egging you guys on to say, oh, cool. There we go. What about the other wood planks forming the horns? That is very possible. A little snaggle tooth right here on the end. Yeah, I think something like that could be rad. Yeah, floorboard or... Cockhorn leghorn. Should we redo the chicken?
Cockhorn.
I'll say suck it. Sugar's here. He was just doing some texting. Yeah, it is like 60 degrees out. The Arctic chill of July in Washington. Taste the rainbow. Why do I think cock is the most frequent word for this stream? Art. College is going to be a bitch. I've decided what I'm going to do. You're going to be a bitch? I didn't quite get that. I didn't get that sentence. What are you going to do, Roger? I'm going to college to be a bitch.
You have to go to college for that?
Yeah, right? Yes. I got a BA in bitchery. You know. Cigars are. What's up, dude? Yeah, exactly. Tyrone's like throwing shit out there like, you know, Like, he's concerned that we use the word cock so much on this stream.
Whatever.
Yeah. You started it! Yeah, we heard you talking about the cock fall on the Jub-Jub and, you know, Journeyman. I know you go around to other artists now and you're like, yeah, your shit's all right, but it ain't no cock fall. And they're just confused. What in hell's name are you talking about? Band. Yes. That's my, Cockfall is my graffiti name.
Yeah.
Yo, Cockfall here, dropping letters.
All your subversive shit needs to go on your new Instagram, Cockfall.
I could. I could do a Cockfall Instagram and do all my political art on there. Little Bukkake Trump. Basis has committed to the cult of the cult. Yeah, there have been some people. I'm going to double major in marketing and creative writing, and then I'll do Japanese and art studio. Jesus Christ, man. If you pull that off, amazing. And we're behind you. Way behind you. I won't ever be able to speak Japanese. Yeah. Mr. Origato Domo. Mr. Roboto. There we go. So he's got a double layer of teeth here. I kind of like that. He's just shredding a rabbit.
Do you speak Japanese already?
Do you speak any Japanese now? Wouldn't it be piss party Trump? Yeah, but I'm just, you know, bunch of lobbyists just throwing ropes all over Trump's face would be even funnier, I think. Yeah. I don't know. I'm not real big on, even no matter what my political shit is, it's just not fun wasting my time on painting something like that. If I could go to college for anything, it'd be physics and astronomy. Fuck yeah.
Oh, I got a rubber.
Okay. There we go. Dude, what if I just did teeth all the way down? Screw the rabbit. The Bite of Time. We'll give it a cool art title like that. Those witty painting titles. No, maybe that's not, yeah, so I'll stick to what I know. And the more you know.
G.I. Joe.
Pork chop sandwiches! The best ones where that guy has the helmet on and you can't hear his voice. It's like, nyew, 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 nyew. He's just yelling at the kids. They're like, what the fuck is that guy talking about? That is sick as hell. I just want to paint this part of the painting and then we're done. Bite of Time. Yeah, I don't do the political shit, you know. Not a fan of it. Why waste my talents on talentless people? Okay, so we have the clock, not the cock. We have the clock face. Yeah. And then, is that about the size of an eyeball? Yeah, sure. All right. Woo! Up, and we'll go around this side. There we go. That was kind of a circle. I just wanted some sort of reference. Go ahead and get that funk. See, See who says I don't use French curves and tin coffee cups and to get those circles. 10 years as a full-time college student. Kind of like the ding, like some naughty wood. Oh, yeah, yeah, it could be. Well, that's the clock part, though, and you know. And then we'll put the, whatever the black part of your eye is called. Iris, cornea, thingamahoob. Yeah. Retina. Pupil. I went through every other part. Useless shit. I've deleted it from my databanks. Iris, corneum, pupil. Yeah, iris is the color part, right? Cornea is the part you're like, ah, I scratched my cornea. Get the hands. There we go. All right. It's already looking weird as shit. We're on the right track. Clock Paul. I'll be back. Damn it. Okay, Arnold. Love it. Yeah. I'm trying to think what to do. I do like the boards kind of wrapped around. Even if they're maybe wrapped around, like if I had a... Maybe go with more traditional, just... Yeah, let's think about that a minute. Maybe horn chimneys, horny chimneys. Blowing my painting again. Let's hold off on that for a minute. Start working a little bit further down. I haven't quite figured out what I want to do for the top of the head yet. I know I want kind of that roof. Pitched roof like the cuckoo clocks have. But also, maybe not. I don't know. Let's see what it looks like without it. Yeah, right? Do you think the clock would have kept the rabbit's left foot for good luck? Oh, yeah. Do we need a few rabbit's foot hanging from the eave? I think we now... Get the fascia board back on here. There we go. I think we now have just... figured out why there needs to be a roof. And then, yeah, we'll put a few, hang some rabbit's foot. Yes, he does keep them. We could put little horns on the end. I like those twisted, like, satanic goat horns, but I don't really have a lot of room for those. Let's see if we can't just fuck around with maybe some horns that kind of twist like that. Was it Bathus or what's his name, the satanic goat? Yeah. Aren't they? Dollar store, man. 10 mechanical pencils for a buck or some shit. Pink Pearl Eraser, it's still the best eraser out there. And it's dollar store. Pencil sharpener, dollar store. Sharpies, dollar store. All that useless shit that they try and charge ridiculous prices for it. And even Walmart. You can definitely get it for cheaper. Pink Pearl's not as good with charcoal. Oh, yeah, I mean, do you use an eraser with charcoal? I didn't know you could. I thought you just fucked up and threw the paper away. Damn it. Ah. That's butt horn. I'm drawing off camera too.
You guys say something.
That horn kind of over. There we go. Hey, remnant of the moon. Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Welcome back. Glad you could join us. It's always a good time to chime in when the chorus of the song playing is, hey, fuck you. We play very welcoming music here. How are you doing this fine evening? What is it, like plank shingling or something used for cedar roofs? Yeah, cigars are, I might know, right? Aren't you in building and contracting, construction, kind of that realm of things? Sad I missed yesterday's stream. No worries. I left the painting inside. I have to go get that a little bit later. But we finished up the kitty cat. Some bright gold shiny paint, and there he is, yeah. These could actually be tree roots if I planned it out right and did, you know, like maybe a tree root horn combination. There we go. Something of that nature. There we go. Trying to put some lines that indicate which way it's curving from. I like this dude. Cedar shingles, like cedar shingle sheets, right? Thick ones that look like cut by hand of different sizes, all uniform thickness. And cedar turns gray, right? Aren't those the ones that look really cool and then they turn to like shit gray over the years? I never understood why people wanted that. I like how it looks initially. This is so not fitting on a pipe. At least, not all the horns. Alright. Oh, here, let me, real quick. Let me throw up a, little Facebook thing that says I'm on air right now, because if I can get some of my weirdo friends from Facebook to join in, we could take Cock Paul to the next level. Whoa. On air now. Long live Cock Paul. Did I spell that right? Yeah, okay. There we go. Boom! Oh, but it put up the thing about the twisted metal art. That's weird. Unless you apply linseed oil every year, it's expensive to care for a wood roof. Yeah. I got metal. I'm surrounded by woods, and just like having that, you know, when the forest was on fire across the street, knowing I had a metal roof was very comforting. I will always have metal roofs from now on. And I thought they were going to be like super loud, like when the rain hits, and they're not really. And I find usually what people like think are trendy and really nice looking usually end up being just a pain in the fucking ass to take care of. Metal is best. Metal is fucking best. You're damn right. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, my whole roof was probably about $12,000 to re-roof, like a 1,300 square foot. And then they put in a new skylight and then redid around all my chimneys and all that shit. So, yeah, it's pricey initially, but Remnant's laughing. All right. So I think the horn, we got a nice bed of horns that's kind of coming out, and 800 to 1,000 per 100 square feet. Yeah. Oh, yeah, it lasts quite a while. Got the horns, got the clock face. You know, we'll put probably lettering out here for 3, 6, and 9, 12. You can, there we go. And then the wood planks come around to form his teeth. I really like that effect. And in fact, once this painting's done, I need to figure out a way to 3D model it and actually put out a line of clocks that look like this. That would be tip. It'd be amazing. So how do I... So do we come from the mouth down? Let's see. We want to kind of give it a little bit of a crookedness. A square. All right. Yeah. So a rabbit's foot, just a little furry fucking thing, right? I can fix that a little bit if it needs fixing. I'll reference out one, but just to drop them in so I know I don't forget what I wanted to put there. I don't want to take that suggestion and then not run with it. So there's the rabbit foot. That would be da bomb. Yes, I think so. That is way too. Why are they all the same? What the hell are you doing, Sean? Looks like Martha Stewart hung these damn things. They need to be like lower and of different sizes. And there we go. Yeah, more natural. Like a murderous clock did it. Long live Cockpaw! Oh, my second clip. Love it. No regrets. No regrets. There we go. That way it's a little more. That's the official term. This is going to be a wild one. Dear God. That I kept the on-air now thing for you, so you can use that to post your gun line. Oh, okay, okay. Successful steamy porpoise PMS twin? What? So let's do... No, it's moss, maybe. Here's what we can do, like a lot of knots and stuff in the wood, kind of poke them out. There we go. God damn it, he's crooked. Just compensate by bringing it out a little bit more there, and bringing you in more there. So we'll take the wood that way. That's fine. I'll see your dollar and potato and raise it. What? Discord. I'll try and get my Discord set up by this weekend as well. It's going to alert people. That will be kind of screwing around with my streaming schedule a little bit. Like I said, when I first logged on, I am going to try and stream a larger painting this weekend. Kind of get the camera set up for that and experiment with my buddy's Monty Python and the Holy Grail painting, and then that way I can get it all dialed in for the big one that includes the whale and the MG42 mosquito and the Schmanthipede. So I want to get everything dialed in, lighting, all that good stuff. So I know cigars are even waiting for it. It's coming. What was your oh shit, I'm going to do the art thing moment when you left being a broker? It was just that time. Well, for me, I wanted to be professional before I turned 30. I wanted to go pro. So, and it just so happened, I had this deal come through. Anybody know what a NEGAM deal is? So, if you're familiar at all with subprime mortgage lending, which is a really horrible fucking industry, and that's why there was the big crash in 08. So our company did stuff like that, you know. And there was a loan called a negative amortization, and it really fucked a lot of people out of their homes. I'd never sold one. And I had this old lady call, and she's like, look, I don't care what it does. I'm 80-some years old. I just want $500,000 so I can go have fun. And I'm like, let's do it. And I got 2 points on that commission, so I made $10,000. And then I had my first children's book contract. So they paid me about $3,000 to do this children's book. And so I was like, all right, my bills were maybe few hundred bucks a month, so I was like, now's probably the time to get out and become an artist full time. And it was 3 months before I turned 30, so you know, that money lasted maybe 8 months, and then I was just trying to do every Craigslist art ad. And I mean, I just found a bunch of the art that I did. Like, when I first became an artist, I was just answering ads on Craigslist. So I did like the flea circus. I did like 3D animated, like where you do the front, the side, and the left, you know, whatever view, front, back, left, right view of like these little circus fleas that became an animated film. There was a band called Cirque, which is kind of a techno band. I did a video for them where they filmed a girl in green screen, like a screen walking through a hallway at a school, and but all the lockers in the school and everything was all drawn by my hand. And then I did this other 3D thing. It was all pencil work, a ton of random gigs. Yeah, I have so much random shit I did in the beginning. It was like, met a few cool people. Scott Marcano from Mr. Diablo's neighborhood. He used to like dress up, I don't know if he still does this, like as kind of a devil Mr. Rogers, and tell spooky ghost stories, like kids' stories. And Nancy Hernandez was like this story about this ghost girl that died in a high school, and she came back to haunt all these people. So so I did like a bunch of stickers and stuff like that for him. And yeah, just whatever I could get my whole hands on or a hold of, and that paid, you know, 200 to 500 bucks a gig or something like that. So for an ungodly amount of work. You know, beer label designs, like, I don't even know how much of this shit actually got produced. I mean, like, the flea circus, I actually got the 3D renderings in an email of what they look like based off my drawings, which was really cool. It was the first time anybody had ever taken my artwork and done, like, a 3D anything out of it, or 3D rendering out of it, so it was really cool. But, yeah, I just, whatever came along. Soak magazine, which was like a Maxim, like a men's magazine. So I did political cartoons for them. I worked for Modern Fix magazine, which was a rock magazine. If I wasn't doing like spot illustrations, they would let me interview some of the bands. Like, I interviewed KMFDM and anything like dark and industrial. Almost interviewed Gary Newman, but I had something going on and I couldn't make the phone call. And Screech from Saved by the Bell, I put my name in the hat to interview him. He's got a band. But I would do, like, if they did an article on Nine Inch Nails or Tool or something, I've done, like, portraits of Trent Reznor and Maynard and all that. And I did just about anything, I mean, that came along that was like, okay, I think I can pull this off, or I figured out how to do it or make it stylistically enough to work. So, oh, that'd be cool. You gonna put the shrinking and growing bottles at the bottom of the collection of the rabbit hole? Cars, yeah, Gary Newman, dude. Yeah. Yeah. In fact, I can put them out here in the forest. I can actually, like, maybe kind of bring it around a little bit, and then you know, we can have some of the bottles out here, even, you know, in the woods. It'd be kind of cool. This guy's fucked up looking. It's like some Indian dream catcher came to life and hadn't brushed his teeth in 40 years or something. Nuts. But it's nice to know he can, like, open up and, like, bring things in and then chew on them. And it's my birthday. Right? Thursday. That's right. Happy birthday, dude. You did say it was coming up. Happy birthday. Yeah, this is definitely the weirdest. Woo! I think out of all the paintings we've done. Even the devil with the bourbon barrel had like a cohesiveness and kind of a, yeah, this looks like it'd be on the front of a country bar. This is just, how much acid did you eat? So let's put the bottom of the teeth here, or get the bottom teeth in. They're going to be embedded in the wood down here, but I might even have like another little wood thing. We'll see how it looks with the teeth in. Makes me feel like I actually have to do something on this stream. Like, the welder's spending his birthday here. He's going to be like, this was the worst fucking birthday I've ever had. I was on Twitch. Watching a rabbit eating clock. Fucked up heart is me. Spaghetti heart. That's awesome. Noodle. That's a ramen heart. There we go. Put like a big chunky molar back here. Oh, there we go. He's all, A streamer calls their friendly love noodles. People got some cool emotes. I don't. Never use watercolors. Too light. Too pale. Too frail. I like the acrylics. Because even with washes, I still think they're highly vibrant and more vibrant than watercolor. Just put some gnarly fangs. We could put like a fang in there, I guess. Why don't we just bring this tooth down? Gnarly. Here's a gnarly fang. Let's give him one. He's like, I'm half a vampire. Let's put another one there. There we go. I've never fucked with gouache. Never worked with it. But Holbein, the ink, the one that's the bottle that's just sitting on your on Cigarzar's desk. they make the gouache Disney used to use for their animation cells. So yeah, I don't know. I never messed with it. Any chance I get to bring up that bottle of ink, man? Birthdays, I'm at work, been a shitty mood, but the stream doesn't make it shitty. I mean, you're at work on your birthday, and so I hope we can be kind of weird and crazy tonight. And I'm just out of beer right now, so sorry. There we go. The gum line in there. Clockabitis. Cockpaw demands great welds. Yes. The order of the cockpaw. Salutes your birthday. we're here. We are here to amuse you. It's all about the welder tonight. You got something cool you want to tell me? Fuck off. Go tell the welder. Uh, what would make his night is if Sugar could teleport an edible over my way. I'd pay him, of course. Nice. No, I've never used any of the other Holbein colors. I'm so impressed with the black. I'm exclusive. I'm a one Holbein kind of man. Alright, there we go. Get some juice in there. Little corked bottle. Speaking of edibles, he'll eat one in front of you, though, and inflate your jealousy.
I found one in the drawer.
You found one in the drawer?
Yeah.
Now he's going to eat random edibles that he just found in the motorhome. They got to be yours, because... Because they're not Gwen's. Yeah, no. I don't know if Rachel eats edibles. I mean, it's got weed in it. She'll probably eat anything. He's almost kind of melting.
Oh.
He looks like Slimer as a clock. Right? Put like a little fly. Or put a giant fly. And that's like the, the enlarging liquid. We could definitely do something like that. Or a bee. Give him like one of those fucked up stingers.
Butt plug
singer. Butt plug singer. Santa Claus hat butt plug thing. Now available at the store.
The last of the cookies and cream.
Oh, yeah. Cookies and cream edible. What about a bee? It is a bee. See, I put a stinger on him. I called that first. Yeah, it could be B, and I could actually, oh, yeah, you know what? We'll do a little 710, a little oil reference here. Maybe this is all honey running down, and there's the B, and that way, because it's going on a pipe anyway, so. Done. Yeah, we'll give him a little black stripes, a little black butt. Me and you go to the same spot earlier, yeah, right? Ha, ha, ha. Birthday edible for me. I know, thinking alike here. You're destined for success. You dig.
I even got 45 minutes. I can drive down to the corner and buy some more.
Woo! You might get some next payday. Well, I think you're going to get some, and you're going to wait until you're online here on stream and just give Sugar shit and eat them all. Why did my internet crap out? What a piece of garbage tonight. Jesus. Nah, it's... Who knows what it is? Well, you know what? I can, I think my iPad's on this shit. Let's turn that off for a minute. Oh. Yeah. All right, looks like it's picking up again. Welder's just gonna send pics of him to Sugar and be like, fuck you, I'm high today. Sugar would just be like, great, so am I.
Me
yeah, me too. Hashtag me too. Pound me too. There we go. I don't like this dude. This is a freaking crazy ass monster. This will be a badass dab mat. Definitely. Rabbit's feet, honey. Yeah, it's all going to be honey just dripping down. I'll put a little drip here to remind myself that's what it is. Yeah. Some giant honey monster, and then, like, this, you know, it's a, but it'll be a clock and...
What is this supposed to be, a rabbit?
I don't know. No, the rabbit's hanging himself in the middle.
Oh.
He'll be hung. I mean, I guess that'll... I guess that'll sell. Half one last week, I was done. Last week, the first time I've been so high, I didn't take much. Yeah, let's do a little cracked out B. There we go. There you go, and their stinger is all fucked up. I'll indicate some legs, but I'll put them in with the ink. No point in... If there's any way to avoid a smeary pencil, the less the better. There we go. I'll just give him a big fuzzy face. Boom! B, are we good? Good. Somehow ended up on acid last weekend. Oh, that's always good when you just walk into some acid. It was a good weekend. I blame sugar. He spiked my drink.
Shit, if I had acid, I wouldn't be putting it in your drink.
Yeah, he doesn't
share.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Open your eyelid so I can squirt this in. My buddy Larry did that. Larry was this cook. We called him Snoop. He looked like a white Snoop Dogg.
He's always a cook.
Yeah, this is when I cooked in New Orleans. He was all like, he looked like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, but we just called him Snoop because there was a bunch of black guys working in the kitchen, so they were more into Snoop Dogg than Scooby-Doo. But anyway, Shaggy Snoop, Shaggy slash Snoop.
Dog.
He was walking home one night, or after he finished, and he... Ended up, yeah, he ended up at the Whirling Dervish, which was a goth club, and, yeah, and somebody squirted an eyedropper full of acid in his eyeball. They were like, here, take this. And he ended up, like, 22 hours later, just in the ninth ward, which is, like, it's like the white boy ward, like, you could go in there. The other wards, like where Master P and all them hung out and threw barbecues, you're not allowed at those barbecues.
You're not allowed.
Like, but that's where, like, Vons was and... You've been to the Dervish. Shut the fuck up. Really? And, yeah, so the cops pulled up next to him and they were like, what the fuck are you doing here? Yeah, Remnant, white Snoop Dogg. There you go. As if Snoop isn't white enough. There's an even whiter version of him out there. Yeah.
His best friend used to be Dr. Dre, now it's Martha Stewart.
Yeah, yeah. Snoop's going through that Michael Jackson transformation. But yes, because we were like, where... Oh, he came to work the next day. That's right. And so he was... And this is before we knew the story of him being on acid, and he was just like... all fucked up on the line, and we're like, what are you doing? So we put him on the salad station, and we're like, any moron can make a salad, but this guy, I mean, it was not a salad. It was lettuce on the plate, but yeah. So we finally sent him home, and he came in the next day, and he was just like, yeah, man, I think I've been tripping for like 36 hours. Like, somebody put a whole eyedropper of acid in my eyeball, and I'm like, Jesus. I'm weak. God knows what he was seeing. He's like battling the pasta, you know?
Doing any work on acid is not even an option.
Yeah.
Like, I've tried to make music on acid. I've tried to work on, like, graphics on acid.
Well, that's why, like, everybody's like, oh, do acid. It'll open doorways. Your artwork will be more fucked up. And I'm like, more? I'm like, I think I'm good.
It will be more fucked up.
Like, fucked up looking. Like, it won't be, you know.
Well, you don't do any art while you're on the drug.
Yeah. And I guess I took that the wrong way. Because I hung out with a bunch of friends in New Orleans. They all dropped acid. I was kind of the babysitter. And then we all drew. We rolled out all this paper and then just started drawing. And, yeah, their shit looked like garbage, and mine was awesome. So I'm like, I will never do acid, you know?
The acid is just influence. It's inspiration for after you're off the acid.
Well, they sucked balls off acid, too. Panda, we're talking about acid. What you got? Tag, you're in. No? Okay. Oh, I thought this sounded like a completely different fucking band. There we go. My best art and writing has always been done somewhere. Yeah. There's a severe lack of cock paw in this painting. That's because, wait for it, it's clock paw. Boom. And Kyroon Art's already
actually,
agreed, so...
It's clock
maw. Clock maw. There we go. Cock paw and clock maw. I hope you guys are remembering all this shit. Because when I need the book, the manifesto of the cock paw written, I'm going
to
need all this information back.
It's
so.
A good thing.
Yes, but I don't want to have to go through it. I'm going to hire a ghostwriter to, like, watch all 680 million hours of Twitch streams. And so we're going to have to, like, talk about cockpaw every episode, just so whoever I hire has to go through every episode. Or whatever poor intern. Yeah, I think we talk about it over 50 episodes. Not quite sure. I know it starts with the painting of the cockpaw, but I don't know where it ends. It never ends.
It never ends.
Yeah, it's just there. I'm going to take some goddamn notes. It's just going to be like a book you open up in like 800 pages of just cockpaw, cockpaw, cockpaw. Just repeating over and over.
Acid pasta?
Acid pasta. That sounds like a good band name. We're acid pasta from... Yeah, but like from Lebanon or something. Come on. No, but it sounds like a Lebanese, you know. Or some, you know, maybe Eastern Bloc, like Ukrainian band. Like they didn't quite get the English down. It translated wrong. Like they meant like the Marinara Mariachis or something, and it came out acid pasta when they put it through like the Google filter. Like, you know. Say that three times fast. Jesus.
The Marinara
Mariachis. There we go. I think we came up with a band. All right. Who's on guitar? Who's on bass?
Gotta be able to sing.
Who's on sauce?
Somebody's gotta play the tuba.
And they just come out and dump a bunch of hot marinara on the audience.
Nobody actually plays anything. Yeah.
Have you actually heard any of their songs? No, just screaming. You know.
It's like, when I was a kid, we went to Disney World, went to Epcot Center, and this band, it was a guy and this girl, and they played, like, Irish music.
Oh.
And when they got done, they were like, if you liked us, we're, you know, something, something. If you didn't like us, we're Bon Jovi.
Yeah. We're Bon Jovi. I got bass. All right. We got a bass player. How weird do we want to get with this? Should the rabbit be hanging because he is the pendulum, which I think we'll go with? Or should he be sitting, like maybe his tongue is coming up and the rabbit is sitting on it with like a giant heroin needle shoved through his head? I don't know if the smoke culture would like that, though.
I think a lot of this might be a little too extreme for smoke culture.
They're going to be like, it is a gateway drug. I'm going to turn marijuana into the gateway drug through fucked up art. They're just going to stare at this shit so much, they're going to be like, I have to go do some harder stuff to be around this. That would be amazing. I can't play music. Okay?
You're in.
You're in. You sound like everybody that's in any modern band.
Can you throw hot marinara?
Yes, you're the marinara thrower. Definitely. I got ukulele. You got it. So we got a bass player, a marinara thrower, and a ukulele player.
Sweet.
Done.
Don Ho cover band.
Or what's the Brazilian Kraftwerk? Shit. What's his name? Senor somebody.
Oh.
But they do...
Senor Coconut.
Senor Coconut, right?
Adam Hart.
Yeah, he does the Kraftwerk album cover where it's like... But it's actually like people beating on nuts.
Chicago.
All right, well, whatever. That's how it was described to me, the South American. Not like, you know, necessarily he's... Senor Coconut, that's it.
he did a bunch of fucking, like, bizarre cover shit.
I'll do lighting. Perfect, we got a lighting. It's like School of Rock. I'm just going through my students here, and we got a special project. I got to pay rent. I toured with the Misfits for a summer doing light. Really? He's just making that up. He toured with Misfits, not the Misfits. No. Kai Runart. Yeah. Like on the last tour, like when they did Riot Fest and all that, I saw him, what, like 2 years ago or 3 years ago or whatnot. I think before then, the last time they toured was what, 1963? How old are you? No. He did. Oh, nice. Were you at Riot Fest in Denver? Because I was there selling art. And Chicago. I like this dude. He's fun. He's weird. This is Alice in Wonderland. I remember how much Dr. Chud kept getting slapped by redheads.
Why?
Chud. Cannibalistic humanoid underground dwellers. Amazing movie. Not.
I saw that when I was in fourth grade.
Really?
At a sleepover. At Johnson's sleepover.
I'm sure your parents love that if they knew.
Oh, they did not know.
They were doing a tour in 07, okay. But Jerry only can drink like the devil.
I also saw Videodrome that night. Have you ever seen Videodrome?
Yeah. David Cronenberg, yeah. Oh, I love his stuff. He did Scanners, too, right? And, what was the one about, what the fuck's it called? Mimic something, yeah, that movie was awesome. So good, I forget. All right. I think I'm avoiding the rabbit. How do I want to draw the rabbit? Hanging, of course. Oh, you know what? Let's see here.
What if he was swinging by his ears?
Could be swinging by his ears.
So it's not like overtly death-like, but like kind of. You know, it's more.
Yeah. I mean, I could have his ears like maybe come down. That just looks like he has a vagina in his mouth. Not a bad thing, but I was just pointing it out. And then his head, nose, looking like these little beady little eyes, almost look like Father Rabbit. It's like Bill the Rabbit.
Instead of Bill the Cat,
yeah. You know, like... I think it was Doonesbury, but if I took his ears and maybe tied them like that and then brought them up and then over
I love being
couple other nooses.
Just, like, catching people's reactions, you know, like laughing out loud and shit. And I have no idea what they're actually laughing about, which makes it even funnier.
Oh, she was laughing at the mouth vagina, I'm sure. Because that LOL popped up right after that.
Yeah. I'm just not tracking, you know, because I'm not paying attention to the music.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, let's make him like a Chris Farley rabbit so he actually looks like a pendulum. There we go. All right, I think we got it. Yeah. Okay. See? I mean, I can put his little feet there or whatever, but he's like a pendulum, and the ears come up, and they're tied up here with the rope.
Yeah, like, rather than him looking like he's dead, make him look like the pendulum.
Yeah. Sugar, always the animatarian, the pedo animal lover. You just don't want me to put out death shit for stoners. That was going to be my next business name.
Death shit,
death for stoners.
I mean, skulls are one
thing. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, with this culture, you know, some moron will come up to me at the booth and...
Why are you drawing dead rabbits, man? Like, we're all one love.
Fuck off.
Yeah.
No, one punch.
One love. That poor rabbit.
Death shit for stoners, for the truly gothic stoner. Exactly. I've tried to tell people that. There's a market.
Yeah, there is a market, but you're trying to make something.
This is going to be Chong's choice. Did you know the best way to gut a rabbit is to hold it by its ears, swinging around a couple times, and squeeze its innards out of its ass? Easy. Sounds simple. I'm not going to disagree with that. Because I don't know. I'm just a caveman.
I like that you went from, like, the Queen of Hearts to the Gambler.
To the Maneki Neko. This is how concepts evolve. That's how most films probably started out really awesome, and then it went through the corporate anus and came out Transformers 5, you know. Whatever. Yeah, this is, you know, really far away from an Uber driver. Know? Like, if I'm getting in this car, it better be like, what, Robert Williams, like, hot rod car. Like, we could do that, put some tailpipes coming out of this thing, and we could go really fucking wild with it. But, yes, I love how the concepts evolved. It's all your guys' fault, so. But that's just what happens, you know? And that's okay. It's good inspiration. If you don't think you can come up with concepts, you can just be like, well, we went way off in left field with this dude's last painting.
Survival is immoral. Morals are unnatural.
He looks like the Men in Black rabbit. He ain't a jackrabbit. He's a Men in Black rabbit. There we go. He's got like his agent shades. I think his teeth need to be way bigger. There we go. He needs some like Liberty Bell teeth there. Oh, nice. and put the crack in them. How movies are made. Oh, boy.
That was clipped.
That's a good one. So I finished up my interview for Balls magazine, and Hank Balls, shout out, Stoney Jackson. And I was talking about how art schools don't have business classes. So they basically teach you all this shit about art and how to make pretty shit, but then they don't tell you how to make a career out of it, which is kind of the point of having an education. And so my analogy was like, I said, you know, not having a business class in an art school is like if the Karate Kid learned all that wax on, wax off shit, but wasn't taught how to use it, he ended up just being a kid who cleaned a bunch of nice cars and then had his ass handed to him. You got to know how to use, you know, the pretty shit is just part of the equation, learning how to draw and all that. But if it's not like applied or you're not told how to apply it, there's no fucking point.
Yeah, Cobra Kai!
Cobra Kai. Should we give him a little dick drip?
I mean...
Where's the gimp when you need him?
Bring out the gimp!
Yeah. He's hosting me right now, isn't he? Yep. He might be lurking. He was lurking the other day. There we go. He got his little hands, his little... Yeah, we'll make him a pudgy little Chris Farley button bunny. He's going to compete with Patrick Swayze for Chippendales. I think so. Doesn't the white hair wear a vest? No! Maybe Disney. He's not late for anything. He's been lynched. You know, he doesn't need a vest or a pocket watch or... But there could be a tree branch out here where his clothes are hanging, and it's all about off-camera stuff at this point. We can do whatever. Let's see. No, I don't want to clothe him. I want him to be a big puffball. I think he did wear one in the Disney vest, though, because that's where he put his pocket watch, right? There we go. Whee! Oh, the rabbit. Where did this painting go? Dear God. Love it. I'm going to have to hire you guys on for the think tank. He's a cute puffball. Damn right. Wasn't there a cake or something that people ate to grow? Yeah, there was a piece of cake. There was eat me, drink me, all sorts of shit. Yeah, we can put that out here. We can put a big slab of cake, and let's work on that right now. So let's say some of this honey or whatever. I gotta make a conscious decision if that's gonna be honey, because I gotta draw that very different. He pulled off the rabbit. Looks good. Thank you. Yeah, look at him. He's like, I'm hung. And I like the idea there of not, like, he actually looks like a pendulum, little fat fucker, and then he's up. Yeah, that. Let's see. So a big slab of cake. So let's just kind of build it up here. Let's get the frosting. Oh, guess whose birthday cake this is? Woo! The welder. You will now know that the cake in this painting is for your birthday. See, I can't teleport an edible, but I can make you a birthday cake. There we go. And then we'll just put one giant candle in. It's one of those trick bastards, so you're going to have to keep blowing. Yeah. There we go. And those are usually little spirally candles. Perfect! Happy birthday, bud. And it's got a layer of cream in the middle, of course. There we go. Boom. Yeah. Lots of icing. Boom! He's got a birthday cake. I could put one more ribbon of color in there. Yeah! Alright. This is going to look really weird next to the other two Alice paintings, but whatever. He's an Uber driver. You put the gum line in there, that'll be pink. Got the wooden slats. Moon Witch, what's up? Welcome. You tuned into a wild one. We're celebrating Nanakisi's birthday, the welder. It's his birthday. Say happy birthday. So I drew him a birthday cake in the painting, and we got this clock. This is Clock Paul, who goes with Cock Paul. And he's got teeth that are on boards, and then we hung the white rabbit as the pendulum, and it's still part of the Alice series, you know. This bunny definitely took a wrong turn at Albuquerque.
Cigars
bunch of whores.
Don't mean nothing.
But yeah.
Don't semantics me.
I'm like, that was 6 messages ago? Quit living in the past, sugar. I know. You could landscape just the bee and rabbit, or portrait the rabbit and I. One drawing, two different views. The what? Oh. Just have the bee looking at the rabbit. You're right. We could do something like that. See? My bot is retarded? What? It wouldn't let me LOL because I hadn't been on more for 30 seconds. I don't know how that works. LOL now.
You've been on for more than 30 seconds now.
You can't laugh if you've been... That's the game we play. If you can come into the stream and spend 30 seconds without laughing. Yeah, my bot is retarded. I don't, you know. It's Retard Bot, I think, or Tard Bot or something.
Tard Bot.
Tard Bot was the name of the website I got it off of. I'll be working on that this weekend. I'm going to do some stuff to beef it up and make it all nice. Maybe I'll put something down in the corner here or something, you know. Some spinny shit. Or when you cheer or sub, you'll get your gay dude stripping and a gif or whatever.
Woo!
Whatever you guys want. Whatever your little hearts desire. Your blackened hearts. Let's get some lines going to indicate that he has a deep gullet. I mean, for taking cuts from your drawings or products like you discussed today. Like you could do that and that would fit on the pipe, right? And then that would fit on the pipe. So, I got you. He's going to film sugar stripping? No. You can't sub enough money for me to do that. Actually, I want these, yeah, let's give these candles a little weirdness to them. Boom. Yeah, but I got what you were saying, cigars are, for sure. There we go. Into the mouth of madness. Thank God. Yeah, all right. Now that I put that goddamn candle in there, I'm going to have to do the lighting and put a little fire on there. I'll fuck that up and forget. That's okay. Universal lighting for all. We could put, like... I mean, this shit on the side's not really going to fit on the pipe. It'll just be this part, but which is fine. But I want, you know, different elements in the painting. I love sugar, but I don't want to see that side of him. Birthday suit. Let's see, and then we'll bring the roof back. So some darkness in there. And a little bit of uppers, downers, laughers, and screamers. Cool. Yeah, and we'll do some cool textures. Maybe we'll make this like, we'll put rivets. Be like a porta potty. What do they call them? Portholes. Yeah. Mix between a porta potty and a portal. Birthday suit for. That's right. The welder gets a stripogram from sugar. Let me get these pants off. I brought you an edible. Oh, man. Mouth in. Teeth, bottle, cake, bee, rabbit, more teeth, rabbit's foot, feet, horns. Yeah, kind of like it. Oh, tired of you guys already. How long have I been on? An hour and 21 minutes. Damn. Where's my hydration bot? It's my camping, my tin camping cups. Space and change. Good stuff. Yeah. All right. I think I'm going to stop with the pencils tonight because I am going to screw around with my buddy's painting over here. And my goal is, like I said earlier, to figure out how to just make sure I can get my figure out the setup for streaming large scale paintings, kind of like Pork does with the bigger pieces. So you're right. It is time to get to the coloring book stage. maybe throw some ink in. Why not? I'll do a little bit of inking. What the hell else do I do? No, it's only 10:30 or 10:49. That's awesome. It took less than 8 weeks for that to become a thing. I guess that's pretty slow on the internet. Coloring book. Look at that. Look at that. There you go. That is a thin. Yeah, I mean. Oh, bunch of ink splattered. That's all right. There you go, I inked. You know, let's ink the rabbit in or something. We'll see. Yeah, it's a little bit more. With the other two paintings, I had the sketch completed. This thing was pretty much just. Yeah, eight weeks for coloring book stage. Yeah. 2 days. Yeah, 8 weeks for coloring book stage. 2 weeks for, or 2 days for cockball to get famous. I know where your guys' minds are. Let's see. I'm going to start with this little bee. I like my coloring book phase. I just wish, yeah, once I did it, I had a scanner here that would just scan it in and then release these as coloring book pages. Can we pull them from video, Sugar?
What's that?
Like a still frame on video?
Of what?
Of like the black and white version and print it out as a coloring book?
Possibly.
It's high res, right? No, I don't. I shoot all my artwork on that Better Light system at the print shop, so I don't really need a DSLR. I mean, I could shoot it on my iPad and vectorize it with a program, but I don't really want to vector it either because it takes out all the little nuances in my inking. Vector is some bullshit when it comes to converting my art. There we go. Yeah, we were just talking about that. Yeah, Hairball, what's up, dude? Thanks for the host. And the little freaky Asian guy there. Whoop. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Working on the coloring book stage of the Hung Rabbit. There we go. You could pull, yeah, for sure. I used to shoot all my artwork on it, and man, when I started shooting on the better light, I was like, holy cow. Like, my older prints look like complete garbage compared to this better light system. Let's see. Yeah, this would go good with a honey hatter, though. Actually, this will kind of tie in the honey hatter painting, since it's all honey or tree sap or whatever the hell. It'll actually tie that painting. That painting could be the hatter version for the series, but he doesn't really have a job. Well, I guess neither does this rabbit anymore. He is unemployed. So I can get a clear enough shot and be cleaned up and ready for print. Telling you though, if you see it compared to that, you know. Well, and what they were telling me at the print shop is that the DSLRs are only like 33% accurate because they guess the pixels around them. This is a few years ago, so I don't know where the technology's gone. And then the better light is about a 95% accuracy. So they don't have to do a lot of color correction either. Yeah, I mean, I'm shooting like 4-foot by 3-foot paintings, so. But even my 16, because I think my 16x20s, they use a drum scanner. Photoing line work, you're right. Yeah, if I'm just doing black and white for a coloring book, that. I'm sure that would be good enough. Yeah, I guess I was talking about full color. Or I was talking about full color. So. You'll get your damn coloring book one of these days. The cop. Yeah. The Cockpaw coloring book. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll just have to, like, pull back and let it sit there for a minute, and then that way you can pull the shot. I'm still tripping on you did lighting for the Misfits. That's awesome. people are like, I bet I have a cooler job than you. And you're like, you want to bet on that? How about a gentleman's wager? I need to see if at Sean Dietrich has a wiki so we can add the creator of Cockpool to his page. I don't have a Wikipedia page yet. Someone wants to set that up, go for it. The Order of the Cock Paul. Creator of the Cock Paul. It would be like career highlights. Yeah, he did some paintings and shit, but the Cock Paul. Now I feel so boring. Get back into it, man. Yeah, I got buddies that are like backstage crew, hospitality, all that, and they just... My one friend's like going to Alaska this week for the Cannabis Cup, and then off to Virginia for Lock and Fest to stop in Denver, and I'm like, freaking awesome traveling, you know. I heard Cockpaw. Yes, you did, Panda. I feel like I've already dumbed down my channel. Like, one fucked up word is what draws the people lurking out. I'm like, you can do this and that. We're talking about cameras and business. And then it's like, I heard talk, Paul. Yeah, doing road work's real fucking labor when you get into it. Oh, yeah. Dude, those guys are... But they're fun. Just cool-ass people to hang out with, you know? I always hook them up with shit. I think most of the crew guys running around and Danny Wimmer shows at least have some sort of art or print, bandana, face shields, you know? I'm going to Aspen, Moab, Mirror Lake. Nice, nice, nice. Panda, all right, you're drawing. You're good, you're good. Do what, Sugar?
Genius Pipes.
Genius Pipes. What about them?
The crew.
The crew, the Genius Pipe crew, yeah.
No.
All the crew, yes. They have Genius Pipes. They love those things. Because when you're working the crew at a rock show and you just need to be able to pop something out real quick. Take a toke. Done. Yeah.
Where you at?
Oh. Where are the bandanas over there? I think I showed them off. Yeah, and I got face shields too. The ones that are like tubes and they just go over your head and you just kind of pull them up when you need them. Really cool shit. I should just do this whole painting in black and white. Get to the coloring book phase. All right, I'm done. It was the white rabbit. Kind of indicate the honey there. There we go. That honey.
Oh, I just thought we had open one.
Oh. Yeah, I mean, I try and think of, like, different shit that, like, festivals are going to want. People like festival goers and... Bandanas, definitely... Face shields are really popular. because you don't have to tie them and. The streaming large stuff, a lot of people I talk to set the camera facing an easel and will sit in front of it to do the work. Yeah. Yeah, so that's a. Glad I didn't do that on QVC. That's a face shield. So it's like a tube. You just put it on and then whoop, whoop, kind of pull it up and down when you need it. But that's the Mad Hatter. It's nice. It's stretchy. So they're pretty cool. Yeah, I've got a tripod. I mean, I have a monitor stand I kind of built right here. And then this is, it's got my camera on it or whatnot. So, I mean, it can go 360 degrees and I can lower it. And that's the bandanas. So, nice size bandana. Nice and shiny. But yeah, that's the old Mad Hatter design, the Mad Hatter absinthe. Why are you showing a Sugar's tube top? Hey. Oh, you guys. Because it's the welder's birthday. We're just leading up to the stripogram. Yeah. Sugar's a good sport. Yes, he is. Your name is on a list, and he is going to find you and murder you in your sleep. But he's a good sport. No.
It's all sport, right?
Yeah. Yeah, hunting humans is sport. No. The most dangerous game. Is that like Ice Cube or Ice T or who was in it?
Is that
a different movie?
Based off of a famous short story.
Yeah.
Called The Most Dangerous Game.
I forgot what the movie was called, though. Was it called that?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
And yes, I believe Ice T was in that one. And he was
not like this, right? Yeah, oh
yeah. Didn't have the white guy.
Yeah, you think you're going to have the white dude being hunted? Yeah. Again, Hollywood. Squeezed out of the anus. I mean, they did good with Trading Places. But there was a 90s comedy called The Pest, similar to that. Ah. Which TV did I watch? What was I watching in the 90s? I was watching Liquid Television on MTV. I think all of the 90s consisted of like Headbangers Ball,
120
Minutes, Alternative Nation, Liquid Television, and Married with Children, so I could see Christina Applegate. It was a movie. Okay. Why did I think that was TV? Crazy. There we go. Go up the left side of this dude.
Right.
120 minutes. Time to smoke some weed, Sugar says. Yeah, 120 minutes, Alternative Nation. Ricky Rackman, Headbangers Ball. Kurt Loder, Kennedy. We'll disregard Pauly Shore.
Well, what about Uptown and Downtown?
Julie Brown. Oh, yeah. Kurt Loder was the first one to interview Rammstein because he spoke German. Yeah, he's fluent. Yeah. It's a great way to waste 2 weeks at my grandma's house in the summer. My grandparents.
And before that, you have
Night Tracks.
Night
I don't know if I remember Night Tracks.
USA.
Oh, 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 yeah.
They had their music video shows at night.
Jesus.
On Friday and Saturday night.
Dance Party USA with Nine Inch Nails. Oh, yes, they did that. They did Down In It, and it was hilarious. It looked like they were hired to do, like, the Christmas party for a bunch of accountants. And the way they were dressed, it was, you know, oh, yeah, I mean, big billowy white blouses, and it was awesome. On the men and women. Yeah. Oh my God, I can see Alice as a Spice Girl. That would be awesome. She'd be Eat Me Spice. Drink Me Spice. I watched the Spice Girls video. I think Crazy Like Swayze played the real famous Spice Girl song, and I'm like, I'm really disappointed I had to relive this shit. Yeah, that one.
Dude, I love this Spice Girl.
I mean, as...
Spice World is one of the best fucking movies ever.
I mean, as girls, yeah, they're hot. As a musical group.
They're fucking fantastic.
No. I don't think they were meant to go on at all.
Kai
Runart, thank you for the host. Hell yeah. For one viewer.
I mean, think about what other garbage was going on in pop music.
Oh, yeah. They were pre-Britney, though, right? Spice Girls?
I think they were right around that same time.
Same time, like... I don't know.
Like the early days of Britney.
Auto-host. Word. I appreciate that. Fuck yeah. Has to be Eat Me Spice. Yeah, that'll be Alice's Spice Girl name. She'll have just a little tag hanging off her miniskirt. I knew one way or another, like, Alice would have to be, like, a stripper. I guess we're classing her up by making her a pop star.
Yeah.
At least you don't have... Okay.
Britney was Act 2, starting in 92.
Okay.
The Spice Girls were formed in 94.
Oh. Britney was almost a precursor to...
She was a child at that time.
Was that Mickey Mouse Club? I think a bunch of them were, like, Justin Timberlake and all them. I think they were all, you know. Thanks, dude. I'm glad you like coming here, and we try and keep it real, and I can't believe you guys laugh at half the shit we say. Or at least type it. Mickey Mouse ears? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, wow. Christina Aguilera. Yeah, I believe she was a Mickey Mouse Club, a Mouseketeer as well. Lindsay Lohan. It's funny, they were all these innocent children, and now they're just fucking druggy hicks. No, not the 50s. I mean, I think they had Mickey Mouse Club all over the place. Or isn't it like Doctor Who? Wasn't there like 56 incarnations? Or that's where Baby Metal came from. The Japanese Mickey Mouse Club is all metal bands. And perfume, yeah.
Oh my God, dude! I just did.
No, I didn't see it, but that's the one I was like, is that baby metal? I think I heard it, but I didn't see it. That's, yeah.
Oh, it was like one girl singing all crazy J-pop and
yeah.
The other one singing like fucking total gutter core.
There's another Japanese metal band, something or the Chromosome or something like that. And they have one of the weirdest fucking videos I've ever seen. Weirdest. Probably worst too, but there we go. Alright. The coloring book is here. Fucking with me. There we go. What did I do today? Finished a magazine interview. That was annoying. I don't want to write my own magazine interview. It's an interview. I shouldn't have to do work. It's such a cop-out for the magazine, too. Here, write your own shit. Now, they give me a nice feature. Cool people. Anybody else? New. All right. Yeah, right? I'm going to start a magazine, and I'm going to need everybody in it to interview themselves and write their own articles. What? There we go. Los Angeles Convention Center? I will be in L.A., I think. August 30th and 31st at the Big Industry Trade Show. Doing live art. Pimping my product. I can't believe, yeah, tour starts in like less than a month. 3 weeks if we do this show. Like, what's a girl to do? You should just be like, Sean Dietrich is the best artist with the biggest dick, so in Concussion, you should buy all his shit. I've had the biggest cockpaw. Oh, believe me, I ranted like, yeah. Not maybe not like cockpaw, but. But it was, you know, kind of like, if you haven't seen Sean's art, then you don't know art, asshole. So I hope they like the article. I was like, Sean decided to sit down with this tiny, insignificant magazine. Yeah. It's totally fun to write your own shit. I mean, you basically get to, you know, just brag. I don't like writing about myself, though. Because, like, I've lived it. I don't need to tell myself that shit. It's almost like some nightmarish dream where you're like, I'm going to tell you about your life and you're going to listen. I know what it is. I was there. Okay. Who's Aiden? Okay. Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Mayhaps. Yeah, I like the amount of detail on this one for sure. We're gonna They're going to email you and be like, this seems a little bit self-promoting. He doesn't care. He totally doesn't give a shit. He's like, we're doing a full feature on your art. So I doubt there's any limit to how, unless I start insulting the magazine. he's a really cool dude. Stony Jackson. In fact, he's after he's done putting out this issue, he's touring with Ozzy in Europe. Doing what? I don't know. But I thought that was really cool. I don't know if he's just covering them or he's like a journalist that travels and documents shit or not sure what he does or what he's going to do with on tour with Ozzy. Give him some claws. And there's his little rabbit dick. I mean, it's not a penis, Twitch. No need to ban me. Yeah. I think that only applies to humans, right? Like, the cock paw is fine, and it's not going to get me banned, but... because it doesn't look like a traditional male penis made of flesh. Yeah, that's why I will never stop touring. I mean, I like being out there. I like being in the public. Feel like as an artist, it's your job to be super interesting, you know, but yeah, I mean, well, it's not your job to be interesting, it's your job to paint, but I hear what you're saying. I mean, people have an expectation that you're pretty out of control or whatever, and I'm like, no, pretty fucking normal, question mark, but yeah. That's like bands today. They, the Roxy and California and Hollywood is a whatchamaherb? Was Assemblage 23? They have a big green room, and they were none of the bands party anymore, and so they turned it into a bar, and this is like. So I'm live painting in this upstairs bar where, like, Guns N' Roses used to do cocaine and drink and fuck people. And, you know, it's just like, whoa, you know. Now it's like a lounge. Because the bands that come through now, they play and then they leave. Like, no one hangs out. And that's what the guy was telling me. And I'm like, oh, that's unfortunate. He's like, yeah, so I'm just, why have this huge, really big green room when I can just give them this little closet downstairs they can change in and make some money off this? It's like, why not? It's like, come on, dude, you're in a band. I think everybody's like Rush. Like when everybody was partying, Rush was just like playing Dungeons and Dragons. All right, we are cranking right along on the inks.
You must choose between your records and me, says the girl.
Oh.
Just let this song finish and I'll help you pack.
I don't think I've ever been, you know, before I got married, I was ever in a relationship that really was like, it's the art or me, you know?
I've never been in a relationship like that.
I think they just knew it was the art to begin with, you know? Like, sorry.
if that ever came up and I'm aware of it, I wouldn't have
Yeah. I think you have to do some weird stuff and get some odd stories in your bed. Oh, yeah, to be an artist, for sure. I mean, that's why I moved to New Orleans when I was 20. I was like, okay, if I'm going to get some inspiration, it's probably going to be here. And I did, just the people. I didn't do a lot of art in New Orleans. And, I mean, it was just mainly drinking and working and just talking to the locals and then meeting all the transients that came through. And I mean, I was homeless for a month down there and hung out with all the gutter punks and lived in an abandoned dress factory. And so it was pretty, yeah. And I put all that, like all these weird ideas, it all stems from that, those core memories, you know, of living down there and just remembering the people. I mean, there's some just weird ass people down there, myself included, by the time I'd already put a few months in. You get invited in real quick. To be part of the weird. And they just had really cool places down there to party, so it's not like you had to look very hard. Mississippi University. When I was at Mississippi University for Women, I did a lot of art and ended up in a weird situation like every other day. Nice. I can imagine. Yeah, and all that is, you know, because I knew I didn't want to go to art school. I was like, I'm a painter, you know, like I said, I practice, I get better, blah, blah, blah. I don't need to pay you to tell me that. But the life experience, what I'm going to draw from, what's going to make great art, I got to go live that. So and it's not to say I can't crank out art while I'm doing it, because that's usually how you're going to get introduced to people. But sitting around in a bar drawing, which I did quite frequently. Barnap, got a lot of bar napkins accomplished in New Orleans. You lost a lot of pants there. See, you should do pants art. And each art you can dedicate to that weird situation. Do, do, do. Yeah, there's nothing like being in a bar and drawing. I don't know. I mean, that was one of my monks want to hang out on top of a mountain. Just give me a sketchbook and a bar. Good shit. Endless source of people to draw. And like I said, obviously you're sitting there drawing. People are going to come up to you and then start conversations. I met a lot of people that way. Oh, I drew that off camera. It's like the hills have eyes clock.
Mama.
There's Sloth from the Goonies, maybe. That's what he looks like. I just watched the Goonies today. Forgot how cool that movie was. On. Yeah, exactly, man. It is a documentation, and it's, you know, like I said, a lot of my comic books are, especially, were journals of, like, places and things that I've been, like the girl in the coffee shop who said she wanted to be in the comic but wanted to be in control, and I'm like, okay, well, you're a good-looking Russian redhead, so sure. But it just documented that person, that moment in time, and music, what I was listening to, cities I was in. What's up? How you doing, dude? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Yeah, I was on, yeah, I've been on 2 hours, exactly. I guess it, that doesn't feel like a long time for Twitch. It's funny how sketching and inking, almost every episode is around 2 hours. Like, I've been looking at the archives, and I'm like, it's funny how it almost takes me exactly 2 hours to, like, sketch and ink a new painting, no matter, like, how detailed or how in-depth the conversations get, you know. I thought, like, no, no worries, man. You sent it yours? Cool. Cool, cool, cool. You guys haven't followed. Follow, follow, follow. Yeah, we're just, you know, talking about traveling and how our experiences influence our artwork. And because you can tell, man, you can look at some people's art and you're like, you haven't left the backyard, you know, and it's like, that's the size of it for some people. And that really sucks. I mean, at least they're creating, which is cool. I have no problem with people creating and whatnot, but, you know. But you just want to, you're like, ah, oh, dude, come out. Let's go drinking and then go paint something. You will paint some weird shit. Or have some acid pasta. Sugar's like, food. Yeah, that's why I'm like, there's a lot of dumb art out there. And I, you know, don't mean to be offensive, not calling anybody out in specific, you know, but there's a lot of, and I don't mean it like the person's an idiot. I mean, just the thought put into the painting itself is kind of like, wow, that's the best you got? That's what you brought to the table? You didn't bring this? Come on, man. There we go. Yeah. Aren't they cool? Fuck yeah. How well do you know Pork? Well enough to give him shit for selling his stuff for cheap. We tore him up last night. I just met him online a couple weeks ago, and he was sending a shitload of people over to my stream. And then, yeah, we connected, and we were supposed to have a conversation today. I got to reach out to him. But, yeah, I definitely love his artwork. And I know he's up in Washington, too. So I'd love to have him on my stream, like have him come up to the studio here and do like a little collaboration with me. And I know he's down to do it, so I definitely have the room. And one of the things I'd love to do with this studio is you know, invite guest artists up to come collaborate. Yeah, I think it'd be sick. But I absolutely love his art. Very right up my alley. Thank God someone spells worse. He's not spelling worse. That's the hip way to spell right there. He's cool. Not illiterate. Everybody spells like shit on the internet. Come on. We just want to get the fucking message out quick. All right. Coloring book phase. I like this one. This is going to be a very, very, very wild one. And we'll do, yeah, we'll do some, like, rainbow colors maybe for the rabbit's feet. And it'll be maybe set in a dark forest, but we'll make sure there's a certain amount of, you know, bright, glowy colors. There we go. Nice. Yeah. This I like much better than that. That does look like one of the creatures from Monsters Incorporated. Monsters, Inc. Yeah, right? Yeah, I know they dye them and they, you know, like the rabbit's feet with the neon colors and shit. But we'll see. So there's the ink phase. You know what's next. We'll go ahead and erase what I can. And then tomorrow we'll start dropping in some color. There we go. Yeah, there's just, you know, that's why I like conceptualizing it on stream one night. Sleeping on it and then coming back to it and then going, okay, like how do I really want to draw this painting? You know, how taking in like your guys' suggestions and also bringing like different elements, like the wood planks that have the teeth coming out of it, like stuff that isn't typical. And basically that's a lot of how I construct my paintings is I look at certain sections. So, you know, I looked at the horns and I'm like, I don't want them to be just devil horns, you know? So what if I, you know, and I like those satanic goat looking horns, but then I'm like, well, how do we go one step further? Maybe give them more of a tentacle look to them or whatnot. Yeah. And then moving down to like the clock face and making it more like a portal and then like the boards with the teeth and then. And then it's the welder's birthday. So I had to put a slab of birthday cake in there. And then going, oh, a fly. No, wait, a bee. Oh, it's going to be a dab mat. So why don't we put honey and make it all honey dripping out of the tree here or tree sap or whatever. Honey-soaked rabbit. Yum. There you go. Exactly. So it's funny, you know, even when I'm like in the final process of working the painting, it can change. And that's always a good thing. Especially, you know, it shows you're actually paying attention to what the fuck you're drawing. And it's good to take chances too, and like if one thing worked with a sketch, but then it adds a lot more. Because I think, you know, these horns are adding a lot of action up here, and, you know, it's all kind of the pointing, but this brings it back down, and then you have, you know, these things dripping, everything dripping kind of leading your eye down. And once we put the color in a lot more, it'll bring it, and then we'll probably make this just bright pink with the white rabbit, and everything else will be like yellows and darker tones and whatnot, so this will kind of glow in the middle here. We'll let the birthday candle kind of hit, you know, a little bit of light on this side, and go from there. Got the bottle, drink it, shrink, eat the cake, grow, whatever it was. It could be whatever. Yeah, so I'm going to call it for tonight. We're at the coloring book phase. I will start dropping in color tomorrow. And then this weekend, yeah, I'm going to figure out this big painting here. I got to bang out this Monty Python and the Holy Grail commission really quick. So I'm going to try and get that done by Monday. So I might even just do like a marathon stream or whatnot. We'll see. I mean, all it really requires is kind of moving the drawing table out of the way and putting a canvas here and then getting everything lit and putting the camera up and whatnot. But yeah, I'll start experimenting so I can start working on much bigger paintings, and you know, that way when I'm ready to mural the walls as well and do the motorhome and all that good stuff. So, Garzar, thanks for hanging out, dude. And yeah, let's see, anybody on we can raid? Yeah, can I raid? Let's see. Go raid Journeyman. I know he does super long streams. Yeah, J-Man's on. Cool. Yeah, so we'll go ahead and raid Journeyman. And thanks to Garzar. Yeah, I'm really stoked on this piece. Like, every piece just seems to be getting, like, more detailed, and the concepts that you guys are helping out with in chat are I'm really enjoying the collaboration. So I think that 2020, let the fans dictate my career. We're going to already have that down. So, and there's going to be a lot of cool shit to So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Cheers.